Episode 3076, Are You Afraid of the Scale?
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive by. Happy, happy day. Okay, reach up high in the sky. It's time to stretch because it is Wellness Wednesday. Yes, it is. And I want you to feel good from the inside out and the outside in. But the question remains, are you afraid of the scale? For those of you who are brand new to Creature Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to creaturenow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by AIM, inspiring connection and community. You know, it's easy to become obsessed with a number on the scale, especially when you've been taught to associate your worth with your weight. Are you afraid of the scale? I mean, losing weight and living a healthy life is challenging, especially for those of us who are afraid of the scale. But the truth is, your weight is just a number. While it's important to know where you stand in terms of your weight and overall health, it's equally important to focus on the lifestyle you're creating over time with consistent actions. How long has it taken you to get to where you are today? If you're talking about a decade, then why do you want to lose weight in 3 months? Come on, let's use a little common sense so we don't become obsessive over the number on the scale. Now, you've probably heard the basics of reaching your desirable weight. And that doesn't mean that you want to lose weight, right? You may be one who wants to gain muscle, so you want that number to go up a little bit. Wherever you are on healthy living, you know these basics. Set realistic and achievable goals. We know that. Smarter goals, got it, done it. What about track your progress? Oh yeah, how many notebooks do you have? Day one, day two, day 55, skip 35 days in between, now I'm down to 110 day, you know, we know all those. What about focus on the benefits? Yeah, we're looking at the bright side of things. We know that. Don't compare yourself to others. Ugh, comparison trap, been there, done that, try to stay away from it, but I can't get away from it. And then you also know the other one, patience is key. You got to be patient. You got to be kind to yourself. Now, all of that sounds wonderful, but in a practical sense, it's a bunch of hogwash. How many times have you found yourself in that position yet not reaching what you were going after? Healthy living is beyond tough, and there are so many temptations that lure you in the wrong direction. So let's take a different approach. Extinguish all temptations. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Extinguish all temptations. And that might be getting rid of the children. Huh? No, I'm just kidding. Even though we love them. Yes, we got to keep them, but we do cook for them. However, I want you to look at your environment. What needs to change that you can control? Listen to that again. What needs to change that you can control? Now, that's an important factor. We can want to go away for months or a year and do our own thing, but realistically, yeah, that's not going to happen. It's just not possible. We have too many things going on. I mean, the kids, they need you. Oh, your spouse needs you too. And maybe your boss needs you, right? All of a sudden, it's like, I can't do what I want to do. I know I've been living that the last 6 weeks of my life. I'm like, everybody else needs me, but I need my schedule. I need me. And people are like, no. Come on, Christiane, we need you. We need you here. We need you there. We need you everywhere. So I want you to extinguish all temptations. I want you to look at this completely different. And I don't see very many people talking about this. So we're going to take it room by room. Number one, kitchen. What can be tossed away or cleaned out? Maybe you need to create your own cabinet or area, right? Get rid of the stuff in the pantry that doesn't serve you. Maybe all of you in the family need to get on a healthy kick. Now, you might say, well, my kids aren't going to go for that. And they're the ones who need to keep eating whatever they're going to eat because, you know, they can get a little bit fussy if they don't eat what they want to eat. I get it, whatever stage it is. But this is what you need to look at. If you can't go in the pantry without temptation, then you can't go in the pantry. So that means your spouse needs to cook. Woohoo! Or wait, maybe you're not going to be eating anymore either because your spouse doesn't cook. Do you see the problem here? But remember, this is unusual. You're going to extinguish all temptations. So get rid of the stuff that doesn't serve you in the pantry. Replace it with only what you need for a week, at most 2 weeks at a time. Yes, so if you're buying into those infomercials that say, oh, you buy this set. Okay, I'm telling you right now, how many people have leftovers of that? Oh, I know. I've had a neighbor or two or three bring their extras over to me. I'm like, I used to try that like decades ago. Bring it over if you're not going to have it. And I just want to test and see if it's changed much. I'm telling you right now, it hasn't changed much at all. But we'll leave that for another episode. The taste is still, well, not there. You need to add so many more spices to it. But the problem is we're buying way too much and we don't consume it. And then we go in there and we're like, oh, I haven't even made a dent in this. And then you start to look at yourself between a mirror, on the scale, you feel what it's like to be in your actual outfits, and you're like, I'm not making any progress because you don't see any of the needles moving. The food's not going out where it's supposed to. You're not fitting into what you're supposed to. The scale's not moving like it's supposed to, right? So you're already defeated. You want to set yourself up for success. So don't overbuy for the kitchen. Okay, clean out areas. We did this, maybe it's been a couple months now. Actually, our youngest did that for me. He went in, and I'm one who buys in bulk. I mean, we have a large family. Now I think we're up to like 9, and then we've got the grandbaby, and then that's not counting the grand dog, and then our dog, and then the cats, and it goes on, and then our guests that we have all the time. I mean, our house literally is a party every day, and it's fun. But now it's slowing down a little bit. This summer, we have people going in and out all the time, but not staying after they come in and out. They're mainly coming in, saying hi, and then going back out again. We've got our son who's at an internship in Texas. We've got my daughter who's traveling right now doing clinicals, right? We've got my other son who's doing college and getting ready for all of that. So there's that. I mean, there's just one thing after another. My husband, he's traveling. I'm traveling. We're coming and going all the time. So get in your kitchen and get rid of what is not serving you. Your pantry most likely could be emptied. Get rid of all the expiration stuff. Throw it out. That's what my youngest did for us. He went through it. He's like, Mom, seriously? And I looked at some of the dates. I'm like, oh, yeah, that needs to go. Like, I hadn't touched it since we moved in. You don't need to keep that. Get rid of it. I promise you, you're not missing it. And you're not going to use it tomorrow, even if you keep it longer. Right? And you don't need to use it for that shelter day that you're like, oh, if we're all locked in here for 2 weeks. No, you don't. Toilet paper, maybe, but not some of our canned goods. So get rid of it. You can toss and clean out a lot of what's in your kitchen. Okay, get rid of the processed food. And I really would encourage you, if you have young children, I did this for me years ago, and I do it even now, and my kids aren't that young except for the grandbaby. But with that, I set up an area that's just for me. Number one, the kids know whatever's in that cabinet is do not touch because I need access to it. I've planned for what's in there and I need to be able to use it because otherwise it throws me off and they support me on it. So if you have older kids, explain it to them. You know, Mom is trying to do some things different. She needs to get a little bit healthier. She did everything she did to care for you, right? The body goes out the window when you're caring for the babies. But now it's time to reverse things. And you need to ask your kids, hey, support Mom in this. Support Dad in what we want to do. So the kitchen. Number two, game room or the movie theater room or the family room, any and all of those. It depends. Some, you may have multiples. But do you have snacks readily available in these areas? It could be popcorn bowls. You may have a microwave set up in a room. And you have microwave popcorn right there. You may have hot chocolate for when it's cold up north. I know a lot of people do this. They have hot chocolate right there or tea. That's wonderful. Now, tea is great, by the way. But hot chocolate, not so much. You're just drinking sugar. Oh, yes, it may be delicious sugar, but it's not going to help you live a healthy lifestyle. So maybe you have a small fridge that needs to be stocked differently. Do you have a lot of soda around? Get rid of it. Pack it with mini bottles. And I'm not saying mini as an M-A-N-Y. I'm saying M-I-N-I. Smaller's better. Why? Because you drink it like, oh, I got a whole thing of water down. And you celebrate. You're like, yes. And then you go get another little bottle. Now, eventually you won't need that. But right now, as you are changing your habits, make it easy for your grab and go. Make yourself feel like, oh, I'm important. Like when you go and you get that Pepsi, as my husband would do, and it goes, and it just has this sound to it. You know what I'm talking about? Whatever drink you open, you hear that sound too. And you're like, oh, and you begin to start to salivate, right? Our bulldog is just the same way. Well, not with drinks or anything, not with Pepsi, but with bacon or anything food. And all of a sudden he's just like bubbles everywhere. And I'm like, seriously, dude, you don't need extra bubbles. Don't go bubbles on your mouth. Okay. But change up what's in your refrigerators, especially the little mini fridges, those grab and goes. And guess what? Your children are watching you. So let them see what it means to live a healthy lifestyle. It will benefit them in the long run. So you got kitchen, you got the game room or movie theater or family room. Number three, bedroom. Where are your mirrors? Ooh, maybe you can strategically place them so you are not obsessed with the process of healthy living, right? Why? If there's mirrors all around, you're always looking at yourself. And for a long while, you're not going to still look that great. I don't care if you're trying to put on the muscle or take off the weight. Either way, you're going to be in transition and you're not going to have that transformation. So if you have to literally walk by a full-length mirror 12 times a day when you go to the bathroom because you're a stay-at-home mom and that's what happens, you're not going to feel real good about yourself. Yeah, and it's going to wear on you real quick. And those 2 days are going to feel like 2 months. Okay, let's be real. So where can you put your full-length mirror? Just move them to another room and use it only when absolutely necessary. If you have a hot date or something, then you go look at the full-length mirror. Now, I'm not saying to take off the mirror where you put on your makeup and things like that, okay? I'm talking about those big full-length ones that show everything, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Remove them. Most of them are hanging on the wall, and you can put another picture there, or guess what? Just leave it blank. It's for just a short period of time. And I'm going to tell you this, if your spouse loves you, he or she will support you. I'm just saying, if not, connect them to me and I'll talk to them. I'm just, okay? Because we have got to do what we need to do to help ourselves thrive. Kitchen, the game room, the hangout rooms, the bedroom. Number four, here you go. I bet you didn't see this one coming. Closet. How many clothes are hanging up that you can't wear? They're too small or they're too big. Clear out the clothes that don't fit. Now, you can choose to donate some if you want. I'm not saying get rid of them, but if you know that you will never wear them again, then donate them. Someone else can use them. Or pack them away for about 6 months. You're going to know when your body is changing. Then guess what? You get to go shopping in your own storage area. It's so much fun. My grandson already knows, Grandma, I'm going to go in the garage, go shopping, Grandma, in the garage. It's just funny. Well, that's because I buy in bulk. And I also have other refrigerators out there. So his drinks are out there when he wants his juice boxes. But guess what? He doesn't get a juice box every single time that he wants a drink. He's drinking his water, lots of great water. He's drinking his whole milk, lots of great whole milk. His juice is maybe once, at most twice a day when he's with grandma. Now, mom's a different story. I'm not sure what her rules are. But those are grandma's rules. And so grandma doesn't keep those juice boxes that are oh so tempting in the normal refrigerator. You have to go shopping for them in the garage. Well, you can do the same. Go shopping in your own storage area, whether it's in your attic, upstairs in a guest room. You can go shopping later and be like, okay. And it's fun because you're going to be like, oh my gosh, I forgot how awesome I looked in this. This is adorable. I'm so glad I kept it. A win. Kitchen, the hangout rooms, the bedroom, the closet. Number five. Okay, I knew you had no idea this was happening. The patio, your lanai. Is the furniture comfortable for you now? Depending on your size, you may not want to sit where you used to hang out outside. So change up the area. Now, I'm also saying to you, don't spend a lot of money, but get a chair you want to be in, because who doesn't need to be outside for some vitamin D? You need vitamin D. You need to be outside with the kiddos when they're outside, right? You need to feel good in your own skin right now, regardless of the number that's on the scale. You don't need to be afraid of the scale, but you do need to be outside. So set something up for you. Now, maybe you have a few people in your family and you're like, gosh, this patio set really doesn't fit us anymore. It just doesn't work for us. And guess what? Sell it. Go to Facebook Marketplace. Go donate it if you don't want to sell it. Ask around. You might be surprised. People might say, oh, I'll just take that off your hands. They may even say, hey, I'll give you $100 for it, whatever it is. And then go buy just a couple things. Don't spend all your money because guess what? You're in transition. So you're going to want something different. So get something that works right now for you to get your bottom outside so you can feel good because you're with the vitamin D. And then you can get what you want when you start living that healthy lifestyle full out. Number 6, refrigerator. Now, we've already talked about this a little bit, but I want to specifically talk about it. It's not a room, but it is a room. We all go to the refrigerator. It might as well have its own entity. And most of them are built in. So we're just going to pretend it's literally its own room. What can you replace for your easy grabs? Do you need to have vegetables that are already cut up? Seriously. Then buy them for a little while, easy, cut up, ready to go. If that's a season that you're in, that's a season that you're in. Let me tell you this. If you will eat what is already made that's healthy for you, instead of going and buying food that, oh, you have to prepare, you're going to throw out more food that you have to prepare than that which is already prepared. Say that fast 3 times. Whew, that's confusing. But you know what I'm saying? So what you think you're saving, you're spending that extra $2, $2.50, $3 for a veggie tray, but it's completely ready. And you like every single thing on that veggie tray. You're going to eat all of that before you even go and prep the fresh broccoli, the carrots, the celery, the little tomatoes, whatever it is, the cucumbers, you already have it made. So do that. Now, do you have to continue that for a long time? No. Maybe you only buy it twice. But it gets you in the process of building new habits. It sets you up for success. And then when you open up your refrigerator, oh, it looks so cool. It's like, wow, my refrigerator's clean. It's like you want to enter it. You want to jump in. Like if you were a little troll or something, you're like, oh, if I could just be little and jump in there and see all this awesomeness. And then your refrigerator can be clean. Clean it with a little bit of vinegar and water. Kills everything, sterilizes it. It will smell good and fresh. Then put a brand new box of soda in there. And oh my goodness, you're set, baking soda that is. You're set to go. And you're going to open up your refrigerator and you're just going to feel like a new person every single time. Get rid of the stuff that's not working. Throw out the things you're like, oh, I knew I was going to use that. And it's there and you've never opened it, but it's like, oh, you know, 4 months old or older. Get rid of it. You're not going to use it. Don't feel guilty throwing it away. You've already wasted the money, right? It's already gone. So there's no reason to sit there and fret over, oh my gosh, I just threw it in the trash can. It's done. You threw it away because you didn't use it the first week you bought it. See, bulk stores, buying in bulk, right? Our box stores, they're great if you're consuming and you have a big family. But it's not so great when your food's wasted, you're throwing most of it out. So really think about that. Budget, look at it. I'm telling you, you're going to save money. You got to know when to buy bulk and when not to, right? There's some things. Now, if you've got little kids who absolutely love to chomp on baby carrots, then my goodness, get the baby carrots at the bulk store. But if you have no one who likes celery, don't go buy those 3 or 4 packs of celery at the box store when you're only going to get through one of them because you're the only one who's eating them. That's a waste of money. Think about it. So, review, kitchen, the game room, movie theater, family room, right? Our hangout areas. The bedroom, your room of intimacy. The closet, your patio. Huh, yes, the room that we don't really call as a room, but we're going to pretend it's a room. The refrigerator. And finally, I want to add this on. It's the bedroom. And I talked about it before, but this is kind of a bonus bedroom thing. How does your bedroom make you feel? Seriously. And this is the intimate part of things. If you are one who doesn't sleep well and there is extra tension, then that in itself can lead to stress and an increase in cortisol. And that's not going to help you at all when it comes to healthy living. You have got to be able to walk in your bedroom and have it so peaceful that you just have this, and you just know you're so relaxed. You're beyond chilled. And you know that you're not physically where you want to be, but mentally you're spot on. You need to look at your bedroom in that manner. And that's why I set it up kind of differently. Okay. You want to look at it from the aspect of your mirrors and how you have it decorated. And then the other aspect is, how does it make you feel? Because if you're one who, you know, maybe you've had a mattress since, let's name it, since you were married, maybe you need to be looking at investing in a new mattress. Now, yeah, that's a chunk of change. I get it. But if your mattress is 30 years old, I mean, come on. You know, there's some lumps and bumps in it that, well, you probably could use another one. Even if it's one that you go buy at the box store, it's going to be better than what you have now. So think of it seriously. You want to be able to create that haven of peace in your bedroom. That's your oasis. And so when you go in there at night, when you wake up in the morning, it feeds your soul. It feeds your spirit, right? Everything that you do for your well-being all works with the mind, body, and spirit. They don't work alone, separate from each other. It's in everything. You've got to look at everything as a 360. So extinguish the temptations. Get rid of what's not serving you. It might be a forever goodbye, or it might be a see you later, alligator. Doing what seems obvious might be the most challenging when you're trying to reach your goals. I get it. But keep in mind, you are looking at a lifestyle. This is not a quick, rich way to say, okay, this is the end of today, as I'm not going to live this way. I want to live this way. And you're just going to flip the coin. No, it's a commitment. Don't rush what needs to be built over time. You got this. Go out, train for life. Love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.